Like every other morning, employees went to office, but their access card didn't punch. At first, people thought there might be some issue with the access gate because none of the colleagues seemed to get in. So around 80 to 90 people gathered there for whom the access was denied. So what was initially appearing to be a technical gate issue was actually a layoff, as these employees later got a message stating that they have been laid off with an immediate effect. This is a real example that I just narrated from a very well-renowned company, which I witnessed few years back. I don't want to take the name because this is not something unique that happens. It happens more often than you and I think. Maybe not in that number, maybe not on that scale, not a mass layoff, but it definitely is the reality. And you must have seen the trending news floating on the social media for a mass layoff of 4,000 people in one go couple of days back. I'm talking about better.com. This company has laid off 4,000 people in one go, and the way they have done it adds more to the pain of those people. Most of the young graduates who pass out from engineering colleges or other graduates as well aspire to step into IT industry in private sector to make a successful career for themselves. But most of them are unaware about this side of the industry. They must have heard news here and there, but most of them believe that this will never happen to them. It is something that happens to other people. So today's video is dedicated to all the young professionals out there who are aspiring to make their career into private sector. Doesn't matter which specialization, which field, doesn't matter. But if you're aspiring to make a career into private sector, you must know about these things and how they come into picture, how fair they are, what are your entitlements in such a scenario, and how you can prove yourself from the negative outcomes of such incidents. Because you cannot prove yourself from the incidents itself, because they are inevitable. That can happen to anyone, anytime. But you can certainly prove yourself to a certain extent or to a great extent to the negative outcome of it. So this is a video must watch for every young professional out there. So with that note, let's get started. There's one more example I want to discuss with you. It's not related to layoff, but it is very important for you all to listen to this example, because this can happen more often than the layoff. So it is a real example that happened with an employee where I was working early in my career. So there was this employee around 5 to 6 years of experience, and he was doing pretty well in the company. He resigned. A usual resignation, he got an offer which was way higher. The position was also good and with good company. So he resigned. Everything was fine. He was determined that he don't want to stay back, though his manager tried to retain him. But he was certain that as the position and CTC looks good, he want to move. So everything was good. He was on notice period. There was 2 months of notice period. So he served that. Towards the last day of that notice period, his team arranged a farewell party for him. So I still remember, because the team was very big and cafeteria became very noisy at that time. Everybody was laughing and cheering for him. People were passing jokes. There was a very light atmosphere. So in middle of that, this guy gets a call, and he takes that call after stepping out from the crowd. So when he came back after taking that call, his face was pale and the reaction was as if he's in disbelief, and his eyes were visibly watery, as in though he wasn't crying, but we all could make out that he is in some pain or in some disbelief. Soon he disclosed that the call was from his future company, which he was about to join the very next day. It was a call from that company, and they said the project he was hired for is not coming, so the company cannot onboard him anymore, and the offer stands cancelled, and he cannot join the company. Can you imagine the situation? Your big team of almost 30 to 35 people is cheering you up for your last day, cheering you up for your next opportunity. You are going to join the very next day, and this is the news you get. Can you imagine the situation? But in that case, lucky for that guy, because his manager was really good. Though we already onboarded replacement for that person, his manager agreed to retain him and he continued to work for that company. But definitely became a joke for many employees. And mind you guys, it was not a startup company, not a small company, a big renowned company about which every single student of India who is studying somewhere, every single student of India knows about the name of that company. I don't want to disclose it because it won't look fair, but this shows, doesn't matter where you work or how great you work, it doesn't matter what the name or brand or greatness of the company is. Such situations can happen with anyone, anytime. So now let's discuss the biggest takeaway from this video, which is how you can significantly proof yourself from the negative outcome of such events. And the number one thing on the list is love your skills, not the company. I'm sure most of you would have heard this phrase endless number of times, but I don't think we consciously practice it, including me. Most of the time we try to glorify the brand that we are working for more than the profile that we are working at, which means we are not paying attention to the skills, the work that we are doing, but we are more bothered about what the brand is, what the company is. Though there's nothing wrong in glorifying the company if you feel good about your company, but the focus should be, I am working as so and so. That is your profile. Company is secondary. Your skills should speak. People should know that you are a software developer, you are a HR. People around you should know you by your work, not by the company's name where you're working. With that, point number two, never limit your earning potential to just one single income stream. Try to have your profile on multiple platforms. This advice would have been totally irrelevant if it was like 10 to 15 years ago. But thank God, we belong in such a blessed generation where everything is possible. You can have multiple streams of income with just one laptop and internet connection. So try to build your portfolio on several platforms, be it freelancing platforms, be it investing platforms, be it on social platforms. Work on diversifying your earning ways since very starting, because if something like this happens, then you will not fall to the rock bottom. You will have something to look forward to and to give you that push back until you are again in a very stable position. So that's very important. With that, moving to our point number three, which is connections are very important. Do not try to burn the bridges behind you. It's not difficult to imagine what would have been the situation of that employee who was about to join the next company, and on the last day they called him and withdraw the offer if his manager was not cooperative enough. If he would have decided to act nasty, egoistic in his last few days just because he was leaving and now he can say and do anything, you can imagine the outcome. So guys, it's very important to have professional connections, and on top of that, to behave professionally. Just because you put down your papers and you are on resignation, do not try to mess things up. Do not try to behave in your ego or talk stuff which is not required. Because ultimately, it's going to hurt your connection, which you never know helps you back someday. Life is full circle. So try to be as professional, poised as possible, even in your final days with the company. Moving on to fourth point, which is be aware of your entitlements. So usually in such situation, when companies let go employees with immediate effect, they pay them the salary equivalent to 2 months, which is usually the notice period. If the notice period is 3 months, they pay equivalent to that. And some companies even go ahead and do some bigger packages, like equivalent to 4-5 months of salary for the employee for that damage. So your job is to be aware of that entitlement. If there are any other conditions which were promised to you during your offer, can be related to ESOPs, can be related to stocks or things like that. So you should be aware of this, and you should ask for it if it is not already provided. You should inquire about it tactfully. Behaving or asking with ego, aggression, frustration, anger will not work out in these situations. And I know it's inevitable to feel such emotions. If somebody has laid you off all of a sudden, obviously you will feel all these emotions. You will be angry, you will be frustrated, you will be depressed. But your job is to tactfully address to such issues, and that will only happen when you are aware of your entitlements. Also, it's equally important to be aware about all of these terms and conditions, even if you are not being laid off. I mean, you should pay attention to the terms and conditions on which you joined a company. This notice period thing is for both the parties. It's a cushion for both the parties. An employee can resign and serve notice period of 2 months and leave. So company can also give a notice period of 60 days or whatever the notice period is, or pay the equivalent amount and tell the employee to leave. So it's for both the parties. I know it sounds really rude when you hear it, but it's pretty fair on the papers when you talk about it. So rather than just dwelling into victim mentality, you will have to work on your skills to be confident enough, to be mature enough, to be confident enough, so that if such a situation comes, you are like, it's okay, if you don't want me, I have 100 other places to go where people will happily welcome me and where I'm required. And that attitude will only come if you value your work, your skills more than the company you are working for, the brand you are working for. So that was it, guys, for today's video. I really hope you derived some value out of it and it act as an awareness session for you all, because that's the agenda. If you have any questions, queries, you can leave them in the comment section down below. You can also choose to follow me on LinkedIn, where all of these things are discussed in more real time. You get to know in more real time as soon as these things happen. So it will help you level up your awareness about the industry. So with that, we came to the end. I'm signing off. You keep on watching more content on Corporate Diaries to be corporate ready. And I'll see you in my next video. Till then, stay safe and healthy. Take care. Bye.